Hello, and welcome to this week's edition of KPSN. As we witnessed at our fall rally on Friday, our Warrior athletes in Pride and Passion Marching Band have a lot to be proud of. Getting outside to wish everyone well as we headed into a busy week of postseason competition was a welcome treat for all of us. Exciting updates to share with you this week as a result of an impressive weekend in all things KP. Our marching band came home from the U.S. Band's national competition late Sunday evening with a second place finish after their incredible performance. They scored a 94.2, earning them second place in Division 3. They were also able to snag best effects and best percussion out of all the bands in their division. KP football, there's nothing else to say. Our boys were absolutely dominant under the lights last Friday night against Chelmsford. The offense was firing on all cylinders with a total of 35 points and 5 touchdowns. However, the real star of the show was the close to perfect defense. They shut out Chelmsford, not allowing a single score the entire game. From the clutch interception from Tommy Brewster to begin the game, to numerous fourth down stops, the defense was outstanding. It was clear that the deadly duo of number 2 and number 6 were back in action as both Crawford Kantov and Rudy Gately scored 2 touchdowns apiece. This was a complete team effort and our Warriors look to bring this momentum to this Friday night at home against the Mansfield Hornets. We have a rematch from 2 weeks ago and a rivalry battle on our hands. Make sure to be there at 7 p.m. to support our Warriors on Friday night and follow at kp.wam on Instagram for all updates.
First of all, for offensively, we're the best back in the state. No one can stop us. First of all, I want to thank all the linemen. Defensively, we killed it out there. Put up a goose egg out there. And that's it.
Yeah, same thing. O-line, very good performance. On my second touchdown, probably the easiest touchdown I've ever scored in my life. I just jogged in the end zone. So, got to give a big shout out to that. Me and Crawl, though, we just like that out here. Come on. Come on, best duo out here.
Come on.
Defense,
two and six. Two
easy
and six.
Sacks.
Come on,
yes, sir. Sully, here you go.
Man, defense played great tonight, put our butts off, the scoreboard says it all.
You know, we came out here, we were ready, we wanted to dominate them, and we did, all right?
Hey, it was a good win for starting from the first quarter, you know? First time giving a team 0 points, so it was really good for our team. It only gets hard from here, so we just gotta work harder in practice and hope for the best.
You know, we were just doing what we do best. We were blocking, running down that line. Come on now. We're gonna make that run, that's all I gotta say.
Feels great. We played great as a team. We're trying to keep it going. Let's make this run.
Just pounding the ball with kills teams for us. We just destroy them up front. Let's go.
Yeah.
The girls volleyball team continued their regular season dominance in the playoffs with a 3-0 win over Chicopee last Friday night. The girls looked very confident out there and looked to continue their dominance throughout the playoffs and hope to bring home the Hockomock title. The girls play Notre Dame Academy tonight at 5 p.m. on their home court. The girls soccer team had an amazing win as a result of a great performance over Westford Academy this past weekend. Coming out strong in the first half, the girls were tied 1-1 going into the halftime. Sophomore Heidi Lawrence started the game strong with an insane goal to get the momentum started for the team. The game would end with a wild finish and the girls coming out on top 2-1 to move on to the next round. They play Bishop Feehan tonight in round 2 and the team needs to step it up as this will be one of the hardest matchups they've had all year. They would love to see some fans make the trip to Attleboro to cheer them on and will likely be an epic battle. Our cheer team finished 3rd out of 11 teams at this week's league meet. It was their best performance of the season and earned them the score that they needed to move on to regionals. That competition will be on Sunday in Marshfield. Last Saturday, our Warrior Cross Country team laced up the spikes for the annual Coaches Invitational Meet. With teams coming from all across the state, the competition was fierce, and some races even surpassed 200 runners at a time. Despite the cold frost in the morning, the sun shined through at the perfect time for some awesome running conditions. Our Warriors took advantage of this perfect weather as 15 of our Warrior runners recorded new PRs and 5 ran away with negative mile splits on the day. Great job to all of our runners, and best of luck to those moving on to the Divisional Championship meet this coming Saturday. The girls' field hockey season has come to an end after an unfortunate loss last Friday night. The team's offense was unable to produce in the 1-0 loss to the Lexington Minutemen. Although the season did not end in the way they wanted it to, the girls ended 2nd in the Hawk with a 12-3-1 record, and the 15 seniors have left the team with a strong presence of leadership. The future looks bright for the squad, as strong play from many underclassmen truly supported them this season. Some of our very brightest and best student athletes have a very big day coming up, a day that will ultimately define the next 4 years of their lives. National Signing Day is when all athletes with college offers officially commit to their teams. The paper that they signed is an official letter of intent, a truly special moment for all these athletes and what they have accomplished. The ceremony will be held on Wednesday, and we congratulate all of our KP athletes who will be taking their talents to the next level. That's all for this week's broadcast. Get out there and support our team with both volleyball at home and soccer at Bishop Feehan tonight. We also have football at home against the Mansfield Hornets this Friday. Our teams are ready to bring some fire to the postseason.